Hi guys, welcome to Beebs Life and the US.
Now this incident, this tragedy, occurred on Monday night. So national television audience watches an athlete at the absolute peak of physical condition. And it's relatively routine tackle by NFL standards. Collapse with massive cardiac arrest and very nearly died. The all that really had died, and we're not for extremely expert medical care being right there on the scene. Now, he received a ton of attention as is warranted, but what has received the most no attention from quality. He's asking a critical question of why this happened. For example, is it a congenital issue? If it is, that's relatively easy to explain. Okay, and maybe this young man unfortunately can't play football again. Okay, what the media tried to do though was set up a diversion, and the NFL tried to set up a diversion. And they claimed it was an extremely rare incident called committee of only. That explanation doesn't hold water at all. Okay, now that didn't stop Tony Fauci from going himself on national TV with DeMar Hamlin and the NFL. So again, we don't know what happened. I realize a lot of folks in the audience are understandably very, very suspicious that the facts are available. I have no idea if they did or didn't. Nobody knows that. But here's the reality. See, most of the people won't even ask the questions, right? And when they did ask a question, then they'll just say, okay, we'll just move on, and we're not going to pressure the NFL.
No. But let's hit the rewind for a second. First, the corporate media, the producers gave this a straight, and they didn't think, they thought it was so perfunctory to have him talk about it. They clearly didn't work into him before the show. They gave straight into the question, this toss at the helm, we'll get the whole story. That was shocked. This shows you the corporate media has absolutely no interest in the real answer, right? As soon as they want to cut away, as soon as the young man sat there goes, well, I don't really want to get into it, right? Now, this is the NFL responsibility. This is not the Buffalo Bills owners. This is not the Buffalo Bills coaches. This is not Mr. Hamlin, right? It's not ABC, it's not the straight man and his producers. This is the National Football League needs to come forward and be blunt about this. Am I incorrect in my seat protest?
Well, you want to, because here's the reality here, and here's the quandary for the NFL, for anybody to be rational about this entire situation, is that if the NFL cannot provide an explanation, if football is that dangerous, that it can be deadly in an instant to someone in peak physical condition, then guess what? We shouldn't be playing football, okay? So if the NFL is really actually illogical, it's
mandatory for the schools. That's something that's not being covered by anybody, correct?
Correct. No, I think it's a recommendation for the CDC for taking a new jurisdiction, it might as well be a capable, right? Okay, from ex-cadre, from Tony Fauci and his ilk, and the blue states will use that as a justification believing I'm warning parents in blue jurisdictions, this is coming your way. Now that the CDC has officially added these new treatments, these new so-called vaccines, to the child vaccination list, it is going to be mandatory for your children. So the time to organize and take action is right now to preclude this from coming school year. Because here's the thing, even if you believe in these vaccines, and I certainly do not, but even if you do, any reasonable, logical person would say, but you know what, you and the kids are not vulnerable, thank God, are not vulnerable to the virus. You never give medicine, you never give any preventive treatment to people for a malady, not a common cure. Okay, that's just a preset on medicine. It's just a logical and ethical foundation. Okay, the idea that we're going to force, perhaps, at the least from the public authorities, strongly recommend these vaccines, these treatments, for children who are not vulnerable to the virus, Steve, that is an atrocity, it's an outrage, and it's clearly leading
first do no harm. Steve, let's pop into the, let's pivot to talk about the lived experience of the American people in the economy, sir.
So the economy, unfortunately, we got terrible news. We talked about it a bit yesterday, but it's worth further inspecting on inflation. The corporate media here, once again, has failed in its duty and wants to sell us on a narrative, right? Inflation has suddenly cooled and some other problems, just as they closed in the middle of the and it was all transitory. That was a lie, and now we got really bad news yesterday. On material update, inflation, the situation is not under control. The Fed doesn't have it under control. No, believe that. Don't take Steve, work. Steve, the bond market is burning on this so far. So if you look at chart number one, this is the yield curve. This is the 2-year versus 10-year treasury yield. And this chart line here is all the way back to the 1970s. I have almost 4 decades of data. I highlight, for those who are watching, not just listening, I highlight the yield curve. That is zero. That is 0%. As you can tell, for all of the last 4 years, the yield curve is positive, meaning longer end rates are higher than shorter. As a normal yield curve, the bond market normally functions how it should function in a proper economy. On a few occasions, there's a moment for the generally times of enormous economic stress, like the 2009 recession, like the dot-com bubble, like the 1987 stock market crash. On these kinds of outlier occasions, the yield curve has recently become inverted. This current inversion is not believed at all, Steve. And just yesterday, following the CPI news, we reached a new low for the yield curve at minus 83 basis points, meaning almost a full percentage point, 2-year yield above 10-year yield. Okay, so worse, it's been the worst inversion since the early 1980s. Over the last time we had this kind of inflation, bond investors, who historically have been the most institutional, the most mathematically based, and the most prescient investors in the world, whereas stock investors tend to be a bit more, should we say, emotional. Bond investors are more important for the direction of the economy. And it's hard to lie or feel this way, Steve. Now that you know the food prices, if it's the right time.
Yeah, but it's a tough one with the 10-year bond is right now, but the audience is out of control. So, hey, this is a full rejection of this is the money speaking. The money is fully rejected, essentially, the Biden business plan. Is that a general way to tell the audience what's going on?
Correct. This is an absolute bond market revolt. Remember, the thing of the bond market is essentially the banker. The banker is revolting against the customer. The customer being the government, the United States. It's a full bond market revolt. And this is why the interest rate, the debt service situation of the United States, our debt, which was always, I don't want to give them credit, it's really important here. And they talk about a hunger cliff. I think this is really important. A hunger cliff is looming because 32 states in America, which have been enhanced food stamps, very juiced up, more generous food stamp allowances than before because of the pandemic that started in 2020, is just about to end. It has to end in March. Right now, Steve, this is what the CBS report says. A family of four is going to see a $328 month per month class to their food stamp allowance. An elderly person who's in the minimum is going to go from $281 a month to only $23 a month. That math there shows in the dark green, those are the states that are about to cut the food stamp allowance. The reality is, unfortunately, now 22 million Americans are on SNAP, which is the acronym for food, what is colloquial known as food stamps. That is 6% higher than it was in 2020. See, the reality is, these people are being taken off food stamps at a time of double-digit food inflation in the United States. The crazy thing is.
$23 you got a couple of dozen eggs, right? Really already now. Short break. Cortez is hanging. I think I go, but maybe for a couple of minutes, I got a draft. We're going to go to England and Europe and talk about the Scottish Prime Minister and dropping out in Chicago. Her pronouns. All next to work.
Ok. Okay, bye everyone, and don't forget to subscribe below and thumbs up to our channel and check out our Beebs closet in HCEB and Mekari, and also check out our beautiful decor in HCEB. Bye bye guys, see you to the next video. God bless you all. Bye.